Olá, muito boa tarde a todos. Bem-vindos aqui à nossa sessão da tarde deste Portuguese Humanity Tech Awards 2021. Durante a tarde vamos ter mais 7 conversas com vencedoras e empresas que apoiam esta iniciativa. E vamos começar logo a primeira conversa aqui com a Filipa e a Nádia. Ao que parece, a Nádia está a ter alguns problemas de rede e, portanto, entretanto, vai-se juntar a nós. Estamos a tentar perceber o que é que se passa. A Nádia é da Natix, uma que patrocina esta iniciativa. Obrigada, Nádia, também por esse apoio. Vamos falar em inglês, porque a Filipa pediu-nos que queria falar em inglês para amigos, quer da Holanda, quer que falem Inglaterra, que possam ouvir. So, let's switch to English. Filipa, congratulations on winning this award. How are you feeling? Are you happy with it? How do you see this opportunity as a winner of the Portuguese Women in Tech Awards 2021, sorry.
Thank you, Ines. Thank you, Ines. And I start, well, I feel great, to be honest. I'm right here, so with my award, right? So I'm really proud of it. And hi, everyone. And I would really like to thank, in particular, the Portuguese Women in Tech, okay, for having this amazing journey and creating this great opportunity to empower and to keep empowering women into the technology world, but also to allow young girls and other women to come to this ecosystem, right? So you have doing an incredible job so far. I'm sure that will continue. I hope that I can, from now on, be more close and part of this ecosystem and help you grow. Second, I would really like to thank, in particular, also the sponsor of this of the Marketing and Sales Tech Award, Natixis. So thank you very much for that. I'm really, really happy for the program. I think that, and for the award. I think Nadia now just joined us, so that's great. Thank you, Nadia, so much. And lastly, but not the least, I really want to thank my family, my friends, and my colleagues, not only from my current company, but also from my previous professional experience, who have not only voted for me, but who have inspired me during my life, my personal and my professional life, and contributed to the person I am today. So, Ines, I'm really, really great. And I think that, wow, it's been a great year so far, and I'm sure that the future will be amazing.
No, that's very good, and I'm excited to see how excited you are with the work that you are doing, and also with this award. But can you tell me a little bit more about your journey so far? Where did it started, and where are you right now?
Okay, sure thing. So, my background, if you look at my background, is actually kind of funny because I'm a proud mechanical engineer from Phil. And I started actually working and having some professional experience very young. So, when I joined university at the age of 18, I joined SHARE, a student consulting organization, basically. And then at the age of 20, I started my real professional experience as a marketing intern at AdClick at the time. So I think it was my first connection. Like, I was an engineer, but I really was into marketing, you know? And then at the age at 20, I actually started also, so I was 20 at Click. And then 2 years later, I started working at Jumia, so previously called Rocket Internet Portugal, at which I was a project manager at a commerce startup company. And then basically 1 year later, when I finished my university, so my integrated master in mechanical engineer, I joined the consulting world back then at PwC Portugal. And I really had the opportunity to be close to technology, so to ERPs, CRMs, other applications and systems, but also to be close to the customer analytics part. And I have to say that I had the chance to participate in big, big programs like Next Best Offer and Next Best Action programs. So a lot of analytics and business intelligence. And that is why right after I had my mechanical engineer's master, I decided to do a post-graduation course in business intelligence and analytics at Porto Business School. And well, After that, at 2018, when I was 26 years old, I moved to Amsterdam to join PwC the Netherlands, this time to join the customer and digital strategy practice. And I have to say that it was amazing because I had the chance to lead marketing and sales work streams in big, big programs, at least in terms of digital transformation programs, but also operating model. So I think it was kind of, I don't know, a life-changing opportunity, I have to say. Then this year in 2021, I decided to return to Portugal, my home country. I joined the customer experience team at Deloitte. And guess what? What is my main focus is precisely marketing automation and sales tech domain. So yeah, I'm really excited. If I look back and I connect all the dots, right? I think I'm a proud engineer, right? Who really wants to bring the best and the greatest experience to our customers. And you can tell me, okay, Filipa, that's great, but how? And it's actually kind of simple if you think about it. You just have to combine the strategy with the technology and with lots and lots of analytics. And that's, I think that's the key, right? To have actually and to provide our customers with the right and offer and the right, so regardless of it is a product or a service that that actually it's something that the client needs and the client wants at the right timing through the channel that makes the most fit to the customer and of course with the appropriate pitch and the great experience. So yeah, I'm really into, I can say that I'm a techie girl. Hi Nadia.
Hi. Hi ladies. Sorry. So this kind of event without technical problems, it's not a virtual event.
Well, I have to say that I think the sentence of the year, at least for me, is Filipa, you are on mute. Or Filipa, your camera is not perfect. So trust me, I know it's you know the drill.
No, but we're happy to have you here. And Filipa was just sharing with us her journey thus far. But I like to ask a question to Filipa because I think it's very interesting. Your profile is like. Because when you think about people that working with marketing and sales, we don't think about someone with a background in engineering. But I also think that you mentioned something that also marketing now has a big component of analytics, big data. And also it shows that your background is actually quite useful for the work that you are doing right now. So I think you are like over... This morning we're talking with a lot of people that no, basically there are very very rarely we find conventional and traditional paths or journeys. And I don't think that is very traditional. But I think the fact that you went through this process is actually what allows you to do what you are doing right now, right?
Exactly. And that's exactly why I started by saying my background is actually kind of funny if you look back and if you connect all the dots, because. Even before, I have to say, when I had to choose, and this is actually something that can inspire, I hope, other girls, but also other boys who are starting university. When I had to choose which course, right, I had something, well, at least it was clear for me that I really like the tech part, the numbers, the challenge solving problems, but I really love the people part. In this particular case, the customer. So I chose mechanical engineer because it was a classic engineer for me, made all the sense, even though for most of people, they are like, how the hell the mechanical engineer got into marketing? And if you think about it, she started into marketing in like her first or second year of the university. So it's kind of really strange, but truth is that I really had something in my mind saying, why don't you connect tech engineer with just something that you really love, that is being close to people, being close to the customer and make a difference. So yeah, it's true, Ines, I heard it a lot. So it's something that I think more and more people are doing that. So that's good. It's not that there is not one path or one right path, right? You just have to go with the flow, do what you like, invest the time, and just trust me, it will take time, but things will come.
Definitely. Thank you, Filipa. Nadia, Natixis has been very active in this diversity and inclusion space. Can you share a little with us like some of the work that you are doing and some also the results that you have? So we would love to hear more about that.
Okay, so first of all, Filipa, congratulations once again. I'm really, really happy to see you speak with this enthusiasm and to be sure that you are a winner and that has a why, and we can truly see your enthusiasm and this is amazing. This is the kind of profile we really need. So, and I was the truth is that nowadays marketing and communication fields, they really need to have more and more people with different backgrounds. So and having this background in mechanical engineering, it really gives you the skills that more and more with this huge digitalization of the platforms and this entire world of marketing and communication, it's more and more important. So speaking about Natixi, so this topic of diversity and inclusion and having more women in the IT, in the IT field, for us it was a big, big priority since the beginning, since we are in Portugal, coming back to 2017, when we started our center of expertise here in Portugal. At the time we had just IT, so just IT services, and it was very scary for us at the time because we were looking at our team and we had at the time only 18% of women, which was very, very concerning. The first thought that we got was, okay, so there is something wrong with our HR process. And that was not true. The truth is that, and doing some research, it's not very hard to understand that we still have very few women pursuing further studies and careers in these STEM areas of science, technology, engineering, mathematics. And the truth is that the problem is really on the market, but the roots of the problem, we quickly realized that they were in the education. Not only the education that we got from our parents, that usually if you have a brother, for example, usually the boy is more directed to this kind of areas, and the girl, oh, you should be a nurse or a doctor or to work in languages or something like that. But also in the schools, because if we think about the 12 years of education that we have before going to the university, we don't have a lot of opportunities to really experiment and to see how the labor market works. So how it is like to work in a hospital, how it is like to work in an IT company, in a consulting firm, things like that. So we decided with our experience of Natixis to really launch a Champion for Change project, really with the aim of sharing our employees' experience with students. So we targeted students between the 7th and the 9th grade, and we started to do a lot of different initiatives, so taking our employees to share their experiences in the schools, bringing the students to the company to spend an entire day with our employees. And so with this project, a lot of other similar initiatives have moved on. So we started to partner up with Portuguese Women in Tech and other initiatives and organizations. And it's amazing because we are really building an environmental and social responsibility project. We have our employees really making an impact in the community around us. And we truly believe that, okay, so next year we won't have more women in our company because we are doing this. But we really believe that with this very simple project, with this kind of awareness that we are bringing to the students, being boys or girls, we really believe that maybe in the future we will have more women knowing about the labor market, the countless opportunities that they have in the STEM areas, and for them to really feel that they have role models, and this is really a thing for them. So you don't need to stick to what society still says to you, that it's better to you because you are a woman, but that you can choose anything. And what I usually say is that this project is very important because we don't really want to tell people that, okay, STEM areas are amazing. No, but sometimes it's very important for any girl or any boy to understand, this is not a thing for me, so I really want to do something else. And that's cool because you saw how it works, and this is the kind of awareness that we really want to bring to the education system in Portugal, starting very slow, starting with some schools, doing this project at the scale that is possible for us, but we really believe that very slowly, step by step, we can really make a difference.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, like, as Nadia was mentioning, it's like it's a long-term project and it should be a long-term focus because it will take time to actually be able to make a difference. Like, that's a very important message. And the second important message, I think we are hearing some noise. Okay. The second message is It's also like, not everyone needs to work in technology, but I think like people need to have the tools, the knowledge to actually be able to make that decision. And sometimes, as Nadia was mentioned, sometimes they will figure out that maybe technology is not for them, or maybe pursuing a career, a very specific career in technology is not for them. But a lot of times they also realize that actually it is for them, and also they can realize the depth and the range of opportunities like that exist in technology. I think we lost Nadia again, but going back to you, Filipa, I have another question. What do you recommend for anyone that is now thinking about pursuing a career? And by saying this, is like, might be someone that is in high school or might be someone that is doing something else, but maybe he's looking at technology as a career. Like, what do you recommend? What would be your advice to these people?
Ines, on that, I'll start by saying one thing that it's a cliche, but for me, it's really a truth that if you do what you love, you'll never have to work a day in your life. And I think this is really important. And also doing a parallel list of what you just mentioned, you and actually Nadia, that how do you know if you love something, right? If you never tried, if you never had that experience. And looking back, at least at me, I was raised, well, by amazing family. And by that, if I look at my grandmother, my mother, both of them are from the science field. So that might explain why engineer, if I think into perspective, right, why it's so natural and why it was an option from the beginning. But not for everyone, it might be an option. So I think that for everyone who is starting a career, who is young and wants to choose a course, regardless of if they thought about engineer or not, about the tech world, I think they should consider all the options, you know? I know that sometimes this is not easy, depending on where you come from, right? But I think it's also, and now looking back at me, at you, and it is at Maddie, it's also our responsibility, at least around our community, to actually ensure that at least we explain the different options, in our case, explain the technology world, not only to girls, but also to boys, right? Because it really depends on where you come from. And I think on that, it's one of the key things is, so have in mind all the possibilities, have an open mind. That would be one of my first recommendations. And second, I think this is also super important because when we think about the technology, right, the tech world, you think, oh, you go to school and you go to the university and that's it. Okay, that's not it. When you go to a school or when you go to a university, they teach you how to study. They teach you how to solve problems. But the heavy lifting is on you. So the big recommendation is be willing to learn because you will have to learn all your life. If you think about technology, the digital world, it changes so fast, so rapidly, every single day, that you'll have to learn for yourself. You have to be willing to try one more time, to experience this, to fail, and to actually success, and repeat this all over again. So another thing that I would really recommend is just have in mind that you have to be able to learn, to continuously learn, to be eager to know more, to solve problems, to challenge yourself every single day. And then I also want to say this, is that if we think about especially the tech world, and let's look nowadays, let's think about what this pandemic situation showed us, right, is that your path depends on you, your option. Even if you just finish a high school, or you are just about to start and you are about to start university, or if you are already in university, or if you are a young professional. The path, it depends on you. You can work from different cities in your own country and work remotely. You can work actually to different companies around the world. You can work abroad. You can work in your hometown. So you can choose. But think about one thing, one of the key things, at least for me, and I think at least we share that, especially in the tech world, is the language, English. Invest in English, okay? At least I think that sometimes we kind of tend to forget that part. And one of the keys to a bright professional life, success, a key that can open multiple doors is English. So I would finish. I think I'm already talking a lot. I'm sorry, Nadia, sorry, Ines, but really, if I think about my brother that is also young, also studying engineer, by the way, but also towards all his friends and all my cousins, etc., It's really be bold, be bright, be bold, want to learn more, be eager to learn more, to challenge yourself and think about this. If you can dream it, you can do it. So trust me, just it's not going to be easy, but the journey, it's at the end of the day, it will be worth it.
No, thank you very much, Philip. I think it was very, very inspiring. We are already over time, but Nadia, just like final words from your side, if you want to say something like, or have a recommendation for someone that is just like thinking about pursuing a career in technology, we'd love to hear from you.
I think we just lost Nadia.
Yes, maybe let's see if she comes back. Just give her a few seconds. Technology is not helping Nadia today. It happens. Okay.
Yeah.
So let's finish here. Filipa, thank you very much for being here. Congratulations on your award. We wish you all the best. You are now also an ambassador for Portuguese Women in Tech, so we want to keep seeing you and see you engage in our activities. We'll be back after this with another session or another conversation, this one focusing on the community leaders. So, Filipa, thank you very much.
And thank you so much. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Thank you.